All right, it is the next day on the job. We just got back. The concrete turned out really nice. We just sprayed it down because it is really hot out. That's also why I have this around my neck, because my neck got a complete sunburn yesterday being out in the sun all day finishing the concrete. We wet it down because we don't want any spider cracking or any problems like that. So we got the whole concrete slab wet right now just to help it cure out a little better. Yo, what's up, Mike? So I'm gonna take you guys on a quick walk along and just show you guys what we did.
You guys been busy.
Yeah, been getting work done. Good to see you again, though.
How you doing, Mike?
How you doing, man?
Doing well.
What did you guys work all weekend?
All weekend.
All week.
Damn. Yeah, not too bad, huh?
All right, so what is going on, you guys? This is Tim Odell with Odell Play Landscape. This is part three to, I don't know how many parts this is going to be exactly. Probably about six parts, I'm guessing right now. But this is the next part to the series. We're going to be mainly focusing on the patio cover in this part. As you can see, the concrete bike path slash walkway turned out really amazing. No cracks. Nice drainage. Nice broom finish. We just gotta take the forms out, wait 30 days, and it will be ready for the kids to ride their bikes on. Since we do have the concrete now in, what we're gonna be focusing on today is the rest of the patio cover. We got the lights in today. We're also gonna be doing drains, since the drains that we figured out are clay drains, super ancient and old. We can't really utilize them, we can't tap into them. So we're gonna remove those and put in some new school, the plastic piping. So we're gonna do 3-inch pipe drains all around the patio. And then we're also gonna be putting a filter cover on them, drilling holes only in the top and putting a couple drains in front of the patio so that all the water is gonna be sloping towards the patio. It's like a big V or a big valley from the patio and the dirt. So all the water slopes right at the edge of the patio. That's why we're gonna be making a drainage system at that valley point. And that's why also we're gonna be putting a filter around the drain so no debris can clog the holes that we put in the drain pipe. And it's all gonna just flow out to the front of the house. We're gonna have to dig underneath that footing over there so we can get the drain pipes out to the front yard. But yeah, so we're gonna be focused on the patio cover today. We're gonna get the LED lights installed and the patio cover should be done probably within an hour or two, hopefully. And then we can focus on drains, and that probably will be the rest of the day, or the day itself right there. So we're gonna get to it. All right, what we're doing right now is we're responding to flashing on top of the wood, the rafters on this house, so that when the water hits, it'll flow down right into the panels without ever having to worry about any water getting back behind. And we're just trying to kind of MacGyver that side over there, since that roof is a little bit lower than this one. So we're trying to make the flashing best suited for both roofs. So everything, so it flows this way and then this way. All right, flashing is installed. We use 3/8 screws to hold them up, sheet metal screws. So all the water will just hit here and then go right into our panel and drain out. Now that the lights are here, what we are doing is doing a layout setup. We got about 19 feet across for the panels. We're gonna divide everything into thirds so that the lights sit center and are equally distanced. So we're gonna be doing about 6-4 off the house, about 6-6-4, and then we're gonna go another 6 feet 4 inches, and then that will give our lights perfectly centered across everything. And then we're going 36 inches off the house center, that'll be light, and then 36 off the header board, and that'll be another light. We actually have the marks right there. That is 36 inches off the header board. And then same for the other side. Okay, I don't know if you guys can see, but we have the electrical wires running down through the spots where we're gonna be placing our lights. I'm gonna get a closer look for you. Now we just gotta make a loop so that they feed each other. And then we're gonna carry this lighting over to the next light. So once we get to that point. So before we can carry the electrical lighting to the next spot, we have to put more panels on. We have to carry the panels all the way to the end of this patio cover, install them. And then the way we carried the electrical wiring to loop it to the other side was we put little notches in the panels as they slid in. And I'm going to zoom in to show you where the notches were so you can see how we did it as we were running the wire. It's kind of hard to see though. All right, so here are our lights in place. Now we're just extending it over. This is where the next one will be. It's about 6-4 inches apart, 36 inches off the house. And we're gonna do the same for the other way. Beautiful. All right, so what we're gonna be doing now is, now that we have both of our holes drilled out for the lighting, we're just gonna measure out the distance, cut some electrical wire, run it through each one of those holes so we have some wire hanging out on each side. We're also gonna be splicing it on top to connect it to the other electrical wire that was running through the hanger channel notches that we made in the panels. The thing that I zoomed in on earlier, it was hard to see, but there's these small little notches on there that we're running the electrical wire through. We're just gonna splice those together on top once we have this piece in that we're putting in right now. So here we are on top, just splicing the live wires together so that we have power for all of the electrical lights. Okay, so what we're doing up on the roof right now is we're just screwing the flashing to the panels. Just in case any wind was ever blow, we don't want this thing to lift off and rip up. So we're screwing them down, as you can see. We're gonna put a covering over the electrical, just like that one. Keep everything safe. I'm gonna get back to screwing these in. So once I got done screwing in all the flashing on top, making sure that it wouldn't blow off, we started putting more of the panels in. Since now the electrical wires are ran, that is done complete. We're just gonna be putting in the panels, then we just gotta put in the gutter system and the rafter tails for the looks of the patio cover. And that will pretty much be it, and we will be complete with the patio cover. And if you guys haven't seen part one, I highly recommend going and checking that out, because the part one was the whole setup of the patio cover and we go more in depth on that. So definitely check that out if you haven't seen it.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so we've been digging drains all day. Also been getting this patio cover all set up. We're almost there, almost all done. But we've been putting a drill through this whole drain to help all the drainage when the everything slopes right to this little valley. We put a little sheathing over it so that no dirt debris can get into the drain. That'll help prevent that. See, so we still gotta get the little sleeve over this drain right here. We're gonna put more drain holes right through here. And then we're just gonna keep falling all the way down. It's pretty deep, pretty deep. Big old footing right here that we had to go under. Water main line. Went deep in the water main. There is the footing and the light on the other side. So we're almost there. We'll pop it up right on this side.
Oh, we don't have enough, man.
All right, so now that all the panels are in, we even have the front gutter piece in. That's where all the water is gonna drain right into. We just gotta set up the downspout still, but before that, we're gonna get the side rafter installed.
And that's what we're doing right now. We're just measuring out the side rafter, making sure it's the right fit, which it was. And we're going to be placing that on. And once we were done putting that side rafter on, what we're doing now is we're just wiring up all of the lights. Pretty simple from here on out. It's color coordinated. Not too much can go wrong from this point. White is your neutral, green is your ground, black is your hot. Make sure you wire, you know, color coordinated, white with white, green is green, black with black. And make sure your power is off. You don't want to get shocked or electrocuted. Once we have all the wires twisted on together, we're just going to stuff all the wires right up into that hole. And that white little plate you see dangling is actually going to be the connecting plate to the lights. They actually just lock right into it. It's a twist on like a lock.
You're just seeing a home, custom home prints. Mm-hmm. It just says here's a plug, here's a plug, here's a plug, here's a light, here's a switch. Here's It doesn't say you run from this plug.
It just shows you where they want it.
It just shows you where the plug.
And now here is the main power feed where we connected everything to. It was the old lantern light they had out here. Don't need it anymore now that we have the recessed lighting in the patio cover. So we're just going to tap right into this power feed right here. Once we do that, we're just going to close it off and we're going to have lighting for the backyard now. All right, lights are working and on. Nice. We got the dimmer switch on. Looking beautiful. Awesome. So the last thing that we need to do for this patio cover was just install the downspout for the gutter system so that all the water drains off the patio cover and doesn't just pool up there. So we're just going to be installing the downspout, and the downspout's going to go right into a drain that we're going to be connecting to. And then of course we got to get the rafter tail ends on to give it that nice finished clean look. Sadly, we didn't get enough of the rafter tails delivered, so we were actually short on that as well. So you won't see a final look of the patio cover until the very end of the series, but you will see it, I would say 99% done. It just won't have the final look of the rafter tails on there. So make sure you guys stay tuned for all the parts in the series so you guys can see how the whole project turns out in the end. It's a really nice transformation. Make sure you guys do like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell to be notified whenever I do post up a new video. I would really appreciate that. It does also help us get noticed more when you do like the videos, because the YouTube algorithm says, hey, people are liking the video and more people can see the videos. So if anyone out there, you know, needs help with a patio cover installation, recommend them to the video. And hopefully, you know, the video was helpful in getting a patio cover installed. Also, leave any questions. I'd be happy to answer any questions you guys have on installing patio covers or any other parts of the series. Anyways, have a great day, guys.